Fruit of spiritual maturity. Reading from scripture, John chapter 15 verse 5. I am the vine, you are the branches. He who abides in me and I in him bears much fruit, for without me you can do nothing. Galatians chapter 5 verse 22 and 23. But the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, long-suffering, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. As believers, we are all called to move and grow from spiritual infancy to spiritual maturity. Now, every growth requires a mark or a means of measure. To know how much growth has taken place, we can only find that out by looking at the outcome or the fruit of that process. Just like a tree, as it grows and leads into maturity, we know the outcome of it by the fruit that it brings up, or the measure that we use to see of how a baby grows into an adult. We see that in obvious outward conditions of their development, be it physical or be it emotional. Similarly, our spiritual growth also has an outcome or a mark of measure, which is the fruit of our spiritual maturity. So how do we bear this fruit? Bearing fruit spiritually only comes with an abiding. As the scripture says, abiding in Christ means to remain, to stay in, to continue in a consecrated, constant, continued relationship with Jesus Christ as Lord. As the verse highlights, we are to be attached to the vine who is Christ, because it is only from him that we have things for life and holiness. Through this abiding, we bear much fruit. So what is this fruit? The fruit of the Spirit is the mark of a spiritually mature believer. It is a physical manifestation of a mature life. When we are yielded to His work in our lives, the fruit will be evident. It will be displayed outwardly in our lives. Just like a fruit tree bears whatever fruit is natural to them, believers in Jesus Christ will bear fruit that marks the measure of their faith, or it marks the measure of their spiritual walk. Believers in Jesus will bear spiritual fruit. So when we look at Galatians chapter 5, there are two lists that are mentioned in this same chapter. The first list talks about the acts of the flesh, the things that are identified in our lives before we received salvation. These acts of the flesh can be labeled as immaturity, immorality, lustful pleasures, hatred, contentions, just to name some. The need for confession is very important here, the need for repentance and God's divine power to overcome the acts of the flesh. The second list that we see is the fruit of the Spirit. That is, when we grow in maturity, the fewer of the acts of the flesh are evident in us and more of the fruit of the Spirit is there. So how do we take time to discipline ourselves? When we discipline ourselves in the things of God, the fruit of the Spirit is manifested in us. It labels 9 fruit that come directly from the Holy Spirit. And we believe these are the attributes or the nature of God Himself, which means it is God's love, peace, joy, patience, kindness, goodness, self-control and faithfulness that is birthed into us and our personalities. These are His divine attributes. So just think about this. God allows to share a part of Himself by allowing the Holy Spirit to transmit this into our own personalities. Spiritual growth is identified by the fruit of the Spirit. Let's pray together. Father God, we thank you for sharing your attributes with us. Thank you for sharing a part of your nature with us. We pray by the power of the Holy Spirit that the fruit of the Spirit will abide and will manifest in us in a greater way. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you for tuning in to Living Supernaturally. For more resources to strengthen your spiritual walk, please visit apcwo.org.